you've written about trying to understand why many white Americans are having difficulty with what's happening in our country right now. Demographic changes, the fact that more minorities are serving in roles of leadership in our country. What are you finding out as you try to understand that?
Yeah, so here's how I think about it. When you are raised in a country that tells you that you are the descendants of a remarkable set of men that created a new country on the idea of equality and liberty and justice and democracy, and you're very proud of that heritage, and then suddenly people come along and say, wait a minute, that story is not complete. We were part of that story too. And not only are they insisting to be part of the story, but now through demographics, through elections, through economics, they are becoming, acquiring more power that they didn't have in earlier versions of America. This is a status loss, and it feels very much like any other kind of loss, like losing money or losing any sort of physical security. It doesn't necessarily mean that they hold racial hatred or that they despise other folks, but it does mean that sense of loss will often cause some kind of backlash to sort of ensure that their stability of identity, of history, of heritage isn't interrupted.
How do you process that when you think about what many white Americans are having trouble with? Is it something you can understand, mm-hmm. do you think? Is any amount of it acceptable or understandable? Or is it just completely unreasonable?
Right. I understand it because it's a human reaction. I don't understand the flat-out racist hatred for other people just because of the color of their skin. I do understand when people feel like, because of racism in our country, they feel like they're being saddled with the blame, the responsibility to fix it all on their own. Like, they are the perpetrators of this, and individually, personally perpetrating this, and everyone else are victims. Some of this is because I grew up around white people in my neighborhood. Some of this is because of my military experience. So I understand the sentiment. What I don't understand is the way it's politically operationalized or weaponized to turn us against one another just so folks can win elections. So the way I deal with it is I often talk about race to conservative audiences, white Americans, by leaning into my personal story. Instead of immediately saying, look at all the racist things happening in America, I talk about my American journey, my family's American journey, and almost invariably people will find commonalities between my family's story and theirs, no matter their race. They've probably got an immigrant story, they've got a story about growing up in poverty or in rural America. And once those individual stories, the human element is some connection, there's some connection there, then you can start talking about some of the structural and systemic issues that the nation needs to address.